Hey, good morning. Sorry, my AirPods kicked in weird. I want to go over a question that I have been asked a lot lately. So everyone knows that this market is insane, right? So not enough people are selling their homes, and we have a ton of buyers, right? So a lot of buyers have reached out to me recently, and they're asking, is now a good time to buy a house? Because quite frankly, the market probably seems a little bit intimidating to people who don't know exactly what's going on. I'm here to tell you the market does not have to be scary. Yes, there is a lot going on. Houses are flying, I guess, off the shelves, one might say, if you were in retail here. But it doesn't have to be scary, and it is still a great time to buy. So there's a lot of good reasons to purchase a house right now. One of the biggest ones is that interest rates are at an unseen or unheard of low rate currently. So, it just varies on credit. I'm not a lender, but we're looking at under 3%, around 3%. I've seen like 2.85. I've seen some people get 2.5. But anyway, it just varies on your credit, of course, debt to income, all of that. Speak with your lender about that kind of stuff. But it's still a great time to buy. You're getting a low interest rate. Houses are being produced still. New builds are an amazing option. There's a lot to be said about the market. Yes, it can be intimidating. Yes, houses are going into multiple offer situations pretty much immediately. But if you have the right agent and you have the right guidance and you've kind of gone over and you understand, you can be prepared and you can be ready for this market. So, a couple of things I just want people to know about this market are, yes, houses at the right price are going quickly. Okay, so let's just say you have a 3-bedroom, 2-bath house. It's under 150. First of all, hello. Second of all, you need to be ready. So if your agent sends you a list, I'm assuming that your agent's got you on a list of houses that are going out regularly. And you see a house and it says just listed, you want to go and see that as soon as you can. Of course, you have to schedule it and all of that and ask your agent and whatnot, but you want to see that as soon as you can. Or if you aren't able to do it, or to go to a showing, ask your agent if they'll do a video walkthrough for you. Believe it or not, I have a lot of clients who have bought houses without having ever stepped foot in them. Yes, I said that. I have had people go all the way to signing the papers on their home without having ever been in it. That is an important, huge, huge, huge thing about having an amazing agent in your corner. So trusting someone at that level is huge. You're making the biggest purchase probably that you'll ever make or you ever have made in your life, unseen. But there are very, very many options. So you can do a video walkthrough, you can do a FaceTime walkthrough, you can of course do an in-person walkthrough, you can have your friend go with you, go for you, whatever works for you, but there's a lot of different options. So if you're stuck at work, you work a normal 9 to 5 and they're like, hey, you've been looking at houses for a while. No, you can't leave. See if they'll do a video walkthrough and take your lunch break, go sit in the bathroom, whatever, and your agent can do a FaceTime walkthrough for you or send recorded videos or both. But there's a lot of different ways to do things. So another thing is that you really need to be prepared by putting your best foot forward. This is not a market where you get to see that 3-bedroom, 2-bath for 150,000 and say, hey, there's this and this that I don't like. Let's put in an offer of 145 and ask for closing costs. That is not happening. Most agents aren't even doing that. It's not gonna win, and it's not anything that we're trying to, hurt you guys or make you spend more, or even a lot of people think we're trying to make more money. That is not the case. We're not trying to waste your time, we're not trying to waste our time, not trying to waste the seller's time, and honestly, it's just not gonna happen. It's just not. I hate it for you. I do. But it's just not going to happen. So as long as you're realistic about your expectations and you know that if the house is offered at 150,000, you're going to have to likely put in an over asking offer, then and you're putting your best foot forward. You're going to put in the absolute highest and best right off the bat. It's kind of about taking the BS out of buying and selling. Haha. But putting your best foot forward, doing the best offer. Listen to your agent's advice. That's a huge one. We work this market on a regular basis. And not to say that you don't know the market, but you may have bought a few houses, you may have bought no houses. We do this on a regular basis and we know what's going on with the market. So we know, you know, what you should be offering in at, and we know some inside scoops, some appraisal prices, what the house down the road went for, just so many things that we are in charge of knowing that you guys may not, that help you make a better offer. So definitely discuss these things with your agent. They'll be able to guide you in the right direction. We're here to help you truly, truly. So just know that. That's really, you know, if you have the right agent, that's all they're going to try and do is help. So hang in there. You may have to put in a handful or more of offers. So just know that right off the bat. If you know that getting into it, don't feel discouraged. You know, the right house will choose you. And that might sound so sappy and so crazy, but truly, if it's meant to be, it will. You'll get that house and it really will fall into place. Another thing is that new builds are a really amazing opportunity right now. Now, new builds vary. So some new builds are offering $0 in earnest money. Some builds are saying they need $5,000 or $10,000 in earnest money. So definitely ask your agent about those questions. Bring your agent with you or tell the new build rep that you are working with an agent. That way you're protected throughout the entire process. But new builds can be a really good offer or an opportunity for you. And having an agent who knows about new builds, because not all new builds are on the market. They're not on the MLS. They're not popping up. You actually have to know a representative from the new builders communities so that you know what houses are coming soon or that are already out, just aren't released, things like that. So keep in contact with your agent. They are trying to help you. Hang in there. Put your best foot forward and just be ready. Be ready to find that one. You know, again, there's so many different ways now that you can purchase a house. And, you know, you'll see a house. If you're a local, you'll see the house before you actually sign papers. But sometimes you may have to put in an offer on a home if you haven't seen it. Get an agent that you trust who will do a video walkthrough, who will give you and show you everything. You know, if there's something that